There's three different ways to change music info on your MP3s. The first one is the quickest and most convenient, but it won't actually change anything. It'll just change the way that the system shows you the songs, but it won't change the actual song's information. And there's two other ways that these are the ones that we want to do. They will change the actual song's metadata, and you can transfer the song between systems and it'll remain with the song. This is the quick and convenient first way to do it. This is good for changing songs in a pinch, or if you plan on using the same phone and the same app to play your music for the rest of your life. First, you're going to go to your respective music player, in my case PowerAmp, and then going through the songs, find the ones that you want to change. In my case, I'll have to hold down the song title, and then there's an info/tags. And then from there, I can click Edit Tags and change all the information inside. I can also add album art, but just remember that if you switch music players, you'll lose the info and the album art, and you can't view the changes and additions that you've made on your computer. And since one of the best things about Android is actually being able to acquire music on your phone and sending it to your computer, this is definitely a negative. While that first approach was the easiest and most convenient, there's a little more common sense way to go about it. You start by going into your file manager, and then going to the music folder, so finding whichever folder that the song that you want to change is in, and then you're going to find the rename option, which for me is done by just holding it down and then there's rename. And then as you can see, you can change the name, and this is a permanent change. It will change the metadata. So that's a step above the PowerAmp or music player change method, but you can't change other information besides the name. So you can't add album art, and it can take forever if you have a lot of songs going one by one by one by one. It will take all day if you have like 300 songs to change. The third and final way is to use an app that's specifically designed for this purpose. MP3 Edit is a very underrated app in my opinion, and it's the one that we're going to be using today. I strongly recommend it. From here, you can change a song's metadata completely, including genre, and I've tested this. I've transferred a song from my phone to my computer, and the changes stuck with it, so that's definitely a plus over the PowerAmp method. It can also search for album art through Google Image Search using the tags that are already in the song. So let's go into a song here, and you just press this button and it will search for the album art according to the title and the album. And usually it's spot on, like I've never had a wrong image come through. You can also group songs by album and edit them all at once. So you can see here, this edits all the songs in the album. It also has a built-in file search to look for songs that might not come up, but usually all the songs come up. I've had one or two that didn't come up, and that's because I Bluetooth them to my phone, but usually it will find them all. And on top of all that, it's free, so there's really no reason to not use this. One thing I like to see in it though is the incorporation of a lyric search and to embed it into the MP3, but all in all it's a very effective and useful app, and I strongly recommend you to go to the marketplace and get it. I'll have a link in the description below. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and if you want you can type in the comments what type of video you'd like me to do next, and I'll try to upload it in a timely manner. Thanks again.